Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this session, we want to create the project structure using TypeScript and React Navigation 6 to continue the design of the pages that we did in Figma in the project. If you visit this page to create a new project, here you can find a command that creates a project with a TypeScript template. Well, we use this command and change the name of the project. Well, the project is created. Now go to the project folder to install the required dependencies. First, we install the core of React Navigation. Then we install its dependencies according to the type of project created. Then we install this library to create a stack for the screens. We can also use this module in styles to have responsive sizes on different devices. Now go to the iOS folder to install the pods related to the modules. So now we go to the project folder to create its structure. First, we delete the app.tsx file, which is actually the initial screen of the app, to create it as we wish. Inside the project folder, I create a folder called src to create a source code inside. Inside this folder, I create a file called index.tsx to introduce it as the executable file of the app. In TypeScript, we specify files that contain JSX code with the suffix TSX, and we create files that contain only TypeScript code with the suffix TS. Well, in this file, I create a function called app to return a simple view for now. Now we need to define the address of this file in index.js, so that when the app runs, this file will run first. Now inside the src folder, I create a folder called assets. Inside this folder, we usually put the external files required by the app. For example, I create an images folder here to put the images we worked with in the previous session for use in the app. Well, I'll move them all to the Images folder. Now I create a file called index.ts to define the path of the images inside it. As you saw in the previous session, we create three different qualities from each image to display the appropriate size according to the screen size. In the component that we use to display images, the appropriate size is automatically selected according to the name of the image. So we use only the original name of the images to define the path of the images. Well, here I define the images using the appropriate names. Now I export the names of the images so that I can use them in other files. So now in the SRC folder, I create another folder called constants. In this folder, we usually put fixed and frequent values in use, such as color codes, string keys, URLs, etc. I create a file called colors.ts in it to put the color code used in the app. In defining a TypeScript file, you can define an interface for it that includes definitions of the types of parameters used in that file. For example, here I enter the names of the colors along with their type. And then I create the color object according to that interface. I have chosen these colors according to the design of the screens in the previous session. So now I create a folder called Screens to create app pages in it. I create a separate folder for each screen and put the body code in a file called index.tsx. Well, in this screen, I create a simple view with a text. And in a separate file, I define its style. For the font size, we can use the module that we installed to increase or decrease it depending on the size of the device. Now here we use the useMemo hook to enter the style we created, and we use it inside the components. In order to be able to use navigation prop on the screen, we need to specify its type in the TypeScript file using the interface. This is how I define it and add this item to use the transmitted parameters in the navigation. In the new version of React Navigation, it's better to import them from the native library. Now using FC, we use the prop we created in the function. Well, we created the basic structure of a screen using TypeScript. Now we can create the rest of the screens in the same way, so that we can complete the stack navigation with them. I use this screen and rename the rest of the screens. Well, 7 screens is created. Now in the screens folder, I create a file called index.ts to export the screens into it. This will make it easier to address them in other files. Now to create the navigation structure, I create a folder called Navigation inside SRC. And inside the index.tsx file, I first import the screens we created. Then I define the main stack using the native stack library. Also, to define the parameters that are moved between the screens, we have to define their type in TypeScript, which because we don't know their type yet, I define them this way. Now I create a function called screens. And create a navigation container inside it. And using main stack, I create a simple stack containing all the screens. Since the page design was full screen, I removed the header from all screens. And now I add all the screens to it. And I define the home page inside the stack. Now I import the screens function into the main executable file of the project, so that we actually enter the initial page of the main stack when the app runs. Well, I save all the files and run the app. And as you can see, we entered the initial screen. So there we go. In this session, we learned how to create a project structure using TypeScript and React Navigation. In the next session, we will start creating screens based on Figma design and structure the project in a multilingual way. Now, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And I'll see you in the next video.